your glory, and the earth of your greatness. Your love is new every morning, and your faithfulness is ever sure. So great to the great, beautiful for us in ways.
Church, may we bow down our heads as we present our offering unto the Lord. Great and mighty God, you are God indeed. You are the God who supplies every need of ours. And today, Lord, we have brought back to you a portion of your blessings over our lives. We pray that you shall receive them, O God, like a sweet-smelling fragrance unto your throne. And we pray that you shall multiply back unto us, O Lord, as you cause them to overflow in our laps and in our bowls. We bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you so much, Pastor Ambrose. Before the second offering, we'd like to invite Mr. and Mrs. Benet to bring their baby for dedication. Mr. and Mrs. Benet, are they in the house? Thank you. Please give them a round of applause as they come. Friends and well-wishers, come please join them. I would like to invite the senior minister to do the baby dedication. Pastor Ambrose, please join us.
Yeah, let's give them a clap offering even as they come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As I saw the man carrying the baby, I was wondering whether it was a miracle or not. But it has been whispered that he's representing the husband because he's not here. So that you also don't get the same interpretation I had. Hallelujah. We thank God for a situation like this because children are a reward from the Lord. And it is in recognition of that you've brought her back this day to commit her into the hands of the Lord. Do you promise? Yeah, what's the name of the baby?
Michaela Nshira Bene.
Do you promise to bring Michaela up in the fear of the Lord so that when she grows, she will not depart from it? If you will, say, I will.
I will.
And on behalf of the husband, are you making that pledge for him? Will you?
I will, Pastor.
Friends, family members, like I always say, this is not for show. This is to show that you are prepared to give spiritual support. Do you pledge before God to give support in all forms, spiritual, physical, gifts, guidance to Michaela so that she will grow in the fear of the Lord? If you will, respond by saying, we will. Shall we pray? Eternal God and Father, this morning indeed we give you thanks. We have cause to rejoice, O Lord, because of this gift. So this day, O Lord, even as they bring Michaela before your throne of grace, Father, we come with hearts of thanksgiving. By reason of this anointing oil, O Lord, we pray that from the crown of the head to the sole of the feet, O Lord, she will continue to enjoy your protection. No plague, none of the childhood diseases will come near this body. Any tongue that will rise against her in judgment, O Lord, we condemn. Any eye that will look at her with an evil eye, O Lord, we blind. Therefore, this day, O Lord, we commit Michaela to your grace. You say you know the plans you have for her. We pray that, O Lord, you will bring her into the fullness of her destiny. Father, we pray that she will be the head and not the tail. That the purposes for which, O Lord, you've given unto the family will be realized. That through her, O Lord, the unity, the love will grow in the family. Father, we pray that you will make everything possible that it takes so that Michaela will be brought up. Even at this stage, O Lord, we pray that you will continue to be her protector. We pray that you will continue to be her provider. And we pray that you will continue to be her shield. Therefore, this day, Michaela Nshira Bene, we dedicate you in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and we welcome you into the house of the Lord and into his kingdom. We pray in mighty name of Jesus, and all the saints shall say, Amen. That's the baby dedication certificate for Michaela Nshira Bene. And they bring a thanksgiving offering. Thank you, and the Lord be with you. Hallelujah.
Thank you, sir. Now, as we prepare to come in with our tithes and thanksgiving and Christ to the Rural World Crusades, I'd like to tell you about two other speakers we had during this week. All the way from Cote d'Ivoire, we had Reverend Mrs. Lillian Sanogo. She's the wife of Reverend Sanogo, and they are our Christ to the Rural World partners. She brought us the word that as Ruths, we should be humble and serve. And through our service will come our growth. In Jesus' name. Amen. We also had Reverend Hehemeku from ICGC. And the word that he brought us was that we may be in our Chronos time. The Chronos time is the now, when time moves accordingly. when it is 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock to 3, when it is Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, as the years follow chronologically. That is our chronos time. And through these times, we may even receive prophecies that we are going to hit big, that we are going to progress, that our businesses are going to flourish, that we are going to marry, that we are going to have children. And yet, in the now, that which is said is not. This will be our wilderness period. And as Christians, we must know that we will go through wilderness periods. But through our wilderness periods, we need to learn the art of waiting patiently. We also need to learn to pray, to fast, to read the word. Till the Kairos time, which is God's time, when his the deliverance of his blessings and prophecies come unto us, arrive. So we must have faith that we always have a Kairos time, and that in God's time, it will be. Hallelujah. Therefore, we'd like to invite Elikem, or Lady Pastor Elikem, to lead us into time of prayer. Let's rise on our feet now. Let us go into a time of prayer and pray that now, even as we are going through issues of life, the Lord is bringing our Kairos now. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This month is our month of performance. We want to take our scripture from Ephesians 3:20. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Hallelujah. We have come to a successful end of the women's convention. We want to firstly thank God. People came from branches. We didn't hear any bad story. We were blessed here spiritually and physically. At least the time spent before the Lord was not in vain. I want us just with a heart of gratitude this morning just to bless the name of the Lord. I want you to just open your mouth and say, thank you, Jesus, for how far he has brought us. At least by grace, we have found ourselves in church this morning. We can say thank God for that if you can't even remember anything to say thank God for. Father, this morning, we want to say thank you, Jesus. We want to appreciate the grace of life on us. We want to say thank you for how far you have brought Charisma ladies. Daddy, it's all been by your grace. It's all been by your mercies. It's all been by your love. We know for a surety, oh God, that the time spent with you is not in vain. We give you the praise, Lord. We give you the honor, oh God. It's only you alone that we can say thank you to, oh God. We have been blessed in so many ways, oh God. And we stand together, oh God, as a team, oh Lord. And we say, Daddy, take your praise and take your glory in the life of every Charisma lady, oh God. Both at headquarters and in every branch, Father. We give you the glory, oh God, and we give you the honor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We want to continue and pray for this month. We are asking that let the power of the Lord be shown practically in our lives this month. This month, we have about just 2 weeks to go. We are asking that let God show up whatever has to be done in our lives. By the end of this month, we should be able to stand and give God the praise and share a testimony that this month, which is the month of our performance, surely there shall be a performance in our lives. Whatever it is, be it for church, be it for work, be it at home, whatever it is, personal, whatever. We just want to lift it before God this morning. And we say, Father, let there be a performance that at the end of this month, we will all stand to share a testimony. Let's open our mouths and pray. Father, this morning, oh God, we commit ourselves unto you again. As a church, as individuals, oh God, we come before you, Jesus, and we say that, Father, glorify your name in our lives one more time. You are the same God yesterday, today, and forever. Have you not said it, and will you not do it? You always do it every time we call on you. This morning, we come before you, Jesus, and we are asking you, Father, that rule and reign in the affairs of our lives. Rule and reign in the affairs of our lives, Father. We are asking you, Holy Spirit, and let there be a performance. Give unto us a tangible miracle. give unto us a physical miracle. Every blessing that we have received, oh God, in the spiritual realm, oh God, we ask for a physical manifestation, oh God, that at the end of the month, oh God, we can stand to say we have moved a step forward in you. We can stand to say, oh God, that Father, you have been good unto us. Jehovah, we raise ourselves before you as a church, oh God, in our homes, in our academics, in our works, we speak progress, oh God, that at the end of this month, oh God, we will stand, oh God, and we will say that Jehovah of a truth, oh God, you reign and you rule in our lives. You reign and you rule in our lives, oh God. We come before you, Father, and we say glorify your name. Glorify your name in our lives. Glorify your name in our lives, oh God. We have none other to call unto, but unto you, Jesus. Unto you, Jesus, we give you the praise. Father, this morning, we come together as your children, and we say thank you that you have brought our Charisma Ladies Conference to a successful end. You have told us in your word that where two or three are gathered, you are there in their midst. And this word you fulfilled in our lives as Charisma Ladies. On every single day, Father, you showed up in a different way. And we give you the praise and we give you the honor for that, Jesus. Daddy, we commit the rest of the month into your hands, Father. We are asking that speedily let there be a performance in our lives, oh God. That, Father, at the end of the day, we will all stand and say, Jehovah, you are good, been good to us. We give you the praise and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Now we'll invite the second service choir to give us a song as we invite also the protocol ladies to come forward with a basket. Even as they come forward, you will come in with your tithes, your offerings, those who were late for the first offering, your Thanksgiving envelopes, and your Christ to the Rural World pledges. Amen.
Life that I live is not Oh, May I have your attention for this week's announcements? First of all, I'd like to congratulate all the charisma ladies who are indeed sharpened to serve. May I have your attention? Monday, new converts classes at 6 p.m. Tuesday, intercessors prayer meeting at 6:30 p.m. at the Travailing Chapel. Wednesday, that is the midweek service. The Wednesday teaching service continues on the theme, moving to a higher level in your prayer life. Topics to be covered include hindrances to prayer, ingredients for effective prayer, intercessory prayer, and possessing the gates of your enemy. Join us every Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. at the Rehoboth Temple to learn to pray more and better. Thursday, prophetic encounter from 9 a.m. to 12 noon at the Travailing Chapel. Marriage counseling classes at 6:30 p.m. at the Crystal Hall. Friday, the breakthrough and prophetic prayer service comes off this Friday at the Rehoboth Temple. Time is 6 p.m. Come, let us travail in prayer to receive our breakthroughs and every expectations of our hearts. Remember, prayer answereth all things. School of Evangelism registration. Registration for the 2016-2017 academic year of the School of Evangelism is in progress. Pick up a form at the Christ to the Rural World desk after close of service. CEM Campus Ministry calling. CEM Campus Ministry, that is the Legon chapter, wishes to congratulate all freshmen and women on your admission into the institution and also to invite all to fellowship with us this and every Sunday at 7 a.m. at the Volta Chapel, Tuesdays at 7:30 at the Sabah Field, and on Wednesdays at the Volta Hall Chapel at 6:30 p.m. The Rehoboth Temple Choir calling. The Rehoboth Temple Choir is inviting interested church members to join the choir. Rehearsal days are Tuesdays at 6:30 p.m. and Saturdays at 3 p.m. at the top of the restaurant. Just Worship Season 5. It's another season where humanity invades the throne room of grace with worship. Don't miss the Season 5 of Just Worship, which comes off on Friday, the 7th of October at the Rehoboth Temple. Just Worship. It's all about Jesus. Logos Book Fair. The CEM Children's Ministry will embark on an excursion to this year's Logos Book Fair, the world's largest floating book fair in a ship, at the Tema Harbor on Saturday, the 24th of September at 9 a.m. The fee for the trip is 15 Ghana cedis. All parents who want their children to be part of this educational and exciting trip should contact the administrator of the Children's Ministry. Interested church members are also welcome. Accra Goes to the Opera. The National Symphony Orchestra presents a night of total musical bliss dubbed Accra Goes to the Opera on Sunday, the 25th of September at the International Conference Center, Accra. The orchestra will present tunes from Sound of Music, Karl Orff's Kamina, Burana, and many more. Grab your tickets for 60 CDs, 100 CDs, and 150 CDs at the ICGC Christ Temple, Charterhouse, or Capital Bank branches and Joy FM. Thank you for your attention and have a blessed week.
Thank you very much. Can we put our hands together and do it better? Well, we have the bands of marriage between Dr. Ofosu Atta Amening of Presbyterian Church of Ghana, Christ Congregation, Kofredria, and Dr. Wilhelmina Ekuia Eduama of SEM. Can we put our hands together for them as they come? They are both medical doctors. And the lady is the daughter of Auntie Mina in protocol. You can see her upstanding. That's her daughter. They are getting married on the 24th of September, 2016. The venue is right here, the Rehoboth Temple, and the time is 12 noon. Then between Mr. Malcolm Etonam Ametepe of SEM and Miss Jessica Teteko Alimo of Nazareth Presbyterian Church, Kwabena. They are also getting married on the 24th of September. The venue will be Nazareth Presbyterian Church, Kwabena, and the time is 1 p.m. Then between Mr. Samuel Mensah of SEM and Miss Sheila Ajete Enum, also of SEM. Samuel and Sheila are getting married on the 8th of October. The venue will be Chandelier Marquee, opposite Trade Fair, and the time is 3 p.m. Then between Pastor John Cato So you didn't wait to hear the lady's name. So listen to her name very well. She's Princess Jemima Day. Princess Jemima Day of CEM. They're getting married on the 8th of October. The venue will be right here, Rehoboth Temple. And the time is 11 a.m. So please take notes. On the 8th of October, we are all coming here. The time is 11 a.m. sharp. We bless God for your lives. Amen. If anyone knows of any reason why they can't get married, speak now or hold your peace. Our quote for the day is simply, marriage is a process. Marriage is a process. It's actually a journey that you will never know the beginning from the end. Amen. Usually you can't tell what 5 years is bringing, what 10 years is bringing. But you trust God on a daily basis. They are marrying here out of faith. Amen. And sometimes when you begin, by the time you are fully understanding what you are into, you probably have grandchildren. This is why you should never have time to be criticizing married people. If you are single, respect them. It's easy to sit back and pass your judgments, pass your criticisms. You have no idea. It's not easy. Don't add to their problems. Don't add to it. Don't contribute to it. Everybody here, you are from your own home, you have your own marriage, you're in your own relationship. Look into your own pot and solve yours. Make yours work. Make it big. Make it beautiful. Because you need to take time to build your home and family. You need to establish your home in order. You need to establish your own home in discipline. Sometimes you'll be busy criticizing and disciplining somebody's and your backyard is spoiling. You won't even know. In the fear of God, you raise your home and your family. You also have to establish boundaries within the marriage and within the home. When you visit a married couple, give them their space. Amen. When you go into the lives of a married couple, give them their space. Don't enter their home and you are all over the place. You are interfering in everything. I said in the first service that it's a women's convention, so I'll talk more to women on this subject. Because the women seem to be more guilty of this. The men don't have time. You hardly see a father-in-law going to his daughter's house. But it's very easy to see we women do it. And we do it to one another. You've forgotten that you were also a young girl before. You've forgotten the challenges you went through when you just got married. You've forgotten how it wasn't easy. And now that you have a daughter or a son-in-law, have mercy on that couple. Amen. When you go and there's a problem, don't go and be taking sides. Ajuan, I mean, there's a problem. Wait, I mean, I'm coming to me today. It's a very bad advice. It's a very bad advice as a mother to go and be punching holes and looking into everything that is going on. You've forgotten that you too, when your husband married you, didn't have money like the way you have it today. Didn't you eat so gari at times and sleep? So if today the young man is, your daughter is eating a little gari and groundnuts, just keep quiet and enjoy it with her. Amen. Don't go in and out. The worst part is when there's a new baby in the house. We are learning, oh. When there's a new baby, sometimes, as a mother, don't go in and out of their room picking. Oh, limit yourself. And yes, sir, am I worrying of no one them? Don't enter their storeroom, their kitchen, their this, criticizing. And now, oh, you're crying to my hino tomorrow, mommy. They can't afford it, leave them alone. You go and buy the cloth for your daughter if you want it. Sometimes the marriage will be better off if we would just give them their space. I'm speaking to young ladies here, don't interfere. I'm speaking to those who already have children, who are married and have children, please give them their space. I'm speaking to prospective mother and fathers-in-law. I said the men don't have time for that. But we, the women, let's be careful what we do. God bless you.
Let's do it better for Mama Jane. Marriage is a process. Shall we please be on our feet? After first service, I was standing outside, and one of our worship team, one lady, came to me, and she said, I've been struggling to come to church. Sometimes even meetings, she's unable to come because she stays beyond Amasaman. But there's one thing about her, she defiles all odds to still come for meetings. And she said, look at it. Somebody came to me saying that the Lord says I should bring you my car. Just give it to you as a gift. Hallelujah. She says she started praying about this in February, that God, I need a car. But how it will come, she didn't know. In Psalm 68, verse 8. It says, trust in him at all times. Not only when it is good. At all times. In good times. In bad times. Still trust in him. And another opportunity we have when we come before God. He says that, and pour out your heart before him. When it's time for worship, take that opportunity. Trust him and pour your heart before him. Come before him because he is God. And he is God alone. Lift up your hands this morning. How sweet the name of Jesus. How sweet the name. Jesus, next standard.
He makes the
you great God is. Let the earth be filled with his glory. In Jesus' most mighty name. Amen and amen. Give the Lord a mighty hand. Be seated. I want to speak to you as, first of all, I want to congratulate the women for having a very great Charisma Ladies Conference. And this morning, the whole of the auditorium was jammed, packed with a very powerful finishing ceremony. Say amen. I want to congratulate Reverend Mrs. Jane Manson for leading the women in the Charisma Ladies Conference. She and her team, it was very great this morning. Say amen. Well, we are here in this afternoon, and I want to bring you a word. I want to do the last but one teaching on my Stepping Out in Faith series. And this afternoon, I want to talk about stepping out in faith with what you have. With what you have. Say, with what you have. And in this teaching, I will prove to you from the word of God that you are not empty. That you were not born empty. You didn't come to this world with nothing. That you are not a mistake. And that God always, most of the time, has deposited something in your life. See, I hear you. And it is very important that you discover what you have, and God will use what he has given you to make you a star. Say amen. In the book of Exodus, chapter number 4, the book of Exodus, chapter 4, and I'm reading from the verse number 1, Exodus chapter 4, reading from verse number 1, and the Bible said, now this was a time when God has appeared to Moses and had used and had promised to use Moses to deliver the people out of Egypt. And the Bible said in the verse 1 of Exodus 4, and Moses answered and said, but behold, they will not believe me, nor hearken unto my voice, for they will say, the Lord hath not appeared unto thee. And the Bible said, and the Lord said unto him, what is that in thy hand? What is that in thy hand? And he said, a rod. And he said, cast it on the ground. And he cast it on the ground, and it became a serpent. And Moses fled from before it. The Bible said, the next verse, and the Lord said unto Moses, put forth thy hand and take it by the tail. And he put forth his hand and caught it, and it became a rod in his hand. Say amen. Say hallelujah. And the Bible said in verse 5, that they may believe that the Lord God of thy fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob hath appeared unto thee. Now Moses was being given a very powerful and dangerous assignment to go to a well-built up Egypt, one of the strongest military countries. They have military might. They have conquered their world. They were the superpower of the world. And here was God sending a one-man army. And Moses said to God, how would the people believe me? How will they know you have appeared? How am I going? Where is my army? Because all these 40 years, he has been on the mountains of Horeb, and the sheep were his subjects. Say amen. Were his subjects. And he had no army. He, when he was in Egypt, was one of their top generals, won a lot of battles for Egypt. But now he had come to Midian, married Jethro's daughter, and they have a beautiful boy called Geshem. And he thinks that his destiny, his lot, his life was going to be wrapped up on Mount of Horeb. And he was going to die looking after sheep. Here was God appearing to him on the mountain and said, go to Pharaoh and tell Pharaoh, let my people go. He said, but how would the people, what am I going to do? What do I have? I don't have an army. I don't have swords. I don't have spears. I don't have horse. I don't have nothing. Then he said, what do you have in your hand? Say amen. And he said, a rod. And the Lord said to him, that is all I need. His speech was impaired. He's lost his skills in battle, but he had a rod. Brother, no matter who you are, you have something. God has deposited something with you and in you. And that thing that looks insignificant, that doesn't look so powerful, is what God is going to use to bring you to your prophetic destiny. Am I talking to somebody here? Sometimes you look at yourself and say, I have nothing. You don't know what God has wired you with. You haven't discovered what you have. That is why you are sometimes jealous of what somebody has. And you were wishing that you were this person or wishing that you were that person. If only I had his skills, I would have made it by now. But brother, God didn't make a mistake by bringing you into this world. When you were a clot of blood in your mother's womb, the Bible said, I knew you and I ordained you to be a prophet unto the nations of the world. So when you were a clot, God deposited a gift in the clot of blood before you became a human being. Say amen. So don't ever tell God, I don't have anything. Do you know that there are people who are born without arms and legs? Guys, no arms, no legs. There's this guy in Australia, we showed his picture again. I want you guys to have the picture. It's called Nick Vujicic. The guy was born without arms and legs. Meanwhile, the guy, ladies, the guy swims, skis, plays golf. The guy is a preacher, a teacher. He is married with two children. Married. The guy has two children. The guy has no arms, but he makes love. I don't get it. The guy cooks. The guy fries eggs. The guy uses the computer with his little toe stuck here. Show it. Have you seen? That's the guy there. Have you seen him? He has no arms. He has no legs. You have arms and legs. And yet, you are telling me you don't have anything. Tell somebody you're a big joker. This guy, Nick Vujicic, was born without arms. Can you imagine? No arms. No legs. The guy is like, whatever. He's married. And surprised, the guy swims. The guy can dive into the water and swim his way back and take some breath and goes back again without arms. I'm standing here. I'm 55. Can't swim. Can't swim. If you throw me to the water, listen very carefully, guys. I don't do one quarter of what this guy does. And this guy, what is even hurting me the more, cry, is that he has entered into my profession as a preacher, pulling more crowd than me. Do you get that? The guy cooks, he has wife, he has two children, he has no arms, no legs. He's also come to be a preacher, a motivational speaker, uses his little toe to do his computer work. You see him on a computer. He talks on phone. The guy lifts this the little toe and picks the phone, and the phone, God, the guy answers phones. You are born tall with arms and legs, and your nose is in the air. I don't have anything. Tell somebody, you have something. God deposited something in you. The only thing is that you haven't discovered what you have. And what you have may be small, insignificant. It can only be a rod. But God will use that little thing and make you a star. If you can only focus on it, if you can only celebrate your uniqueness and your gift, if you can only recognize that I was not born useless, I cannot be born with arms and legs. Look, there is a lady called Helen Keller. This lady called Helen Keller, Google her name, and if you have it, please put it over there. This woman, pastor, was born blind, deaf, and dumb. Can you imagine? The lady has no eyes, can't hear, can't speak. Yet, some of the songs we sing in our worship songs were composed by her. Yeah, is it not true? Put her there. Helen Keller. Google her name. Compose. How does she hear? How do you hear? How do you know how sweet your music is when you can't hear? Guys, if I'm telling the truth, I'm not speaking to them. Yeah. There are people born without this, without, some people are born without that, some people are born blind and they are something else. There are people who are painting with their toes, paint, they are sculptors, they are, some people are whatever, painters, some are this, some are that, and they are making it, breaking through, and the world is celebrating them for what little gift God has given to them, and they have been turned into international stars. You cannot tell me that you were just born empty. Lift your right hand and say, I am not born empty. I have a gift, and my gift will make room for me. Say amen. So Moses didn't have anything except a rod. And God used that rod to carry him through to Egypt. Worked miracles with that rod. His rod turned into a serpent, swallowed the serpents of Pharaoh. The rod touched the tip of the Nile turned into blood. The rod, when they strike it on something, you see flies all over the place. When they strike it upon the water, you see frost coming out. Just said the rod was their army. Just God used that little rod. Something you had that is very small, God will anoint it. God's grace will come upon it. God will elevate it. God will eulogize it. God will put his spirit in that little thing. And you can't believe how far God will carry you with that gift. Say, I hear you, pastor. You can't do everything. As I'm hearing me, I can't swim. I remember taking my children on holidays, and then the hotel we were sleeping in, there was a swimming pool. So my children wanted to swim. So their mother was doing something. So she said, I should take them to the pool. So I took them to the pool. I don't swim. So I went and took my pants, and then I stepped into the water. I stepped there. And I held on to the rails in the corner as they were swimming. Amen. And my children will say, Daddy, Daddy, come. Try and swim. I said, no, I don't swim. I don't swim. I thought you guys just swim when something is. I made sure that my feet was touching the pool when I head out to whatever. As they were swimming, you see my children floating, Jason and them, you see them floating, pop, 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 pop. I'm watching them, yeah. Just speaking in tongues, Kurubaya, blah, 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 blah. I don't swim. It's not my rod. It's not my gift. Say amen. Then my daughter said, Daddy, it's simple. Just do this, put your hand, whatever, do your legs like this, and then you float. I said, really? I don't see how I can float. Look at me. How can I float? I couldn't imagine myself floating. But the way she was persuading me and everything, I decided to make her happy by trying. So I tried and I went just to make sure. Hey, I was on the bottom. What I was entering my nose and my mouth. And I went back to my corner and said, I'm not swimming again. It's because it's not my thing. I don't swim. I'm not a swimmer. I don't play football. I'm not wired with football. I was in class 6 when I played football. They say I was supposed to be number 6. Number 6, you have to run around the other ball. I was chasing the ball. And then half time, then the captain said, yeah, brother Stevie, you hear me? Because they have scored us 3. They said they should remove me from the at all. When you mean free match, me good ball. I couldn't play. Football, I can't play football. And see the statement of the class prefect entered my head that I don't know how to play football. They should remove me from the match. Since that day, I told myself football is not my thing. I don't follow football. I'm not a football fan. The Premier League, English League. One day I asked Isu, what's the difference between Manchester City and Manchester United? He said, Steve, how can you be that dumb? I said, why? What's wrong with you? Manchester City and Manchester United, are they the same thing? He said, no, they cannot be the same thing. I don't know. I thought Manchester City and Manchester United are the same thing. I don't do football. I don't play football. It's not my thing. I'm not wired with it. Give me a microphone. Give me a church. Put me on the crusade ground. That is what I have been wired with. Everybody has his proper gift. Say amen. And that gift, if you turn it around and focus on it and train with it and work at it and love it and celebrate it and skillfully train yourself, one day you will become a star. One day the world will celebrate you. Are you a comedian? It's a gift. There are comedians who are billionaires. Are you a talk show person? It's a gift. Go near Oprah Winfrey. She will tell you how much money she has. Just talking. Footballers, swimmers. There's a guy called Michael Phelps or something. Michael, whatever. Phelps. He's a swimmer. The guy can swim. He has won how many gold medals? Several gold. The guy's rich. Just swimming. Yeah. The guy's rich. Swimming. You know, when you put me in the water, I want to come out of the water. The guy, when you put the guy in water, he's in his comfort zone. If you give Phelps, if you give him a microphone to preach now, you can see that the guy can preach. You can only say, well, people, praise the Lord. It's not his area, and I will not blame him for not preaching very well, because he's not wired with preaching. What is your proper gift? What have you been born with? What were you wired with when you came here? Step out in faith with what you have. Not what somebody has. Not what your father has. But what God has. Your rod. Your rod. Your gift. Your talent. An anointing will come on it. The grace of God will fall upon it. Say amen. Say amen. I was telling the first service, myself and my wife were trying to flick through the channels to watch something, and then I wanted to go to an action movie, because I'm an action movie. I want to see Chuck Norris, Rambo, I want to see hijack of planes and things. Then we turned on some sports. And on the sports, It was a very big sporting event, and there was this lady called Serena Williams. And this lady, Serena, she was playing tennis. Hook, whack, hook. When they play the big noise, so whack, hook. Then she would run small, whack, then come back, whoop. Yeah, whack. When they want to serve, you see her doing this. When they want to serve, then they play, bah! They say, hook, whack. Yeah, it sounded very boring to me because that's what she's doing. Hook, whack. When they close, she won the match, and the commentator said, well, Serena is now the world champion, blah, 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 and she's going home with a whooping $500 million. $500 million! Did you hear what I said? For doing what? Hook, whack. Hook. $500 million! Did you hear what I said? For doing what? Hook, whack. So don't walk around and tell me you have nothing. You have something. Discover it. Work with it. Train yourself. Push yourself. No pain, no gain. Go through the pain. Go through the challenges. People will discourage you. People will not celebrate you. They think it's a useless gift. Brother, stay with that useless gift. Stay with that thing. Develop it. And one day, you shall be going home with a whooping 150 million. Shout, hey! Did you hear what I said? $500 million. For doing what? Hook, whack. Mike, the place they are playing the tennis is no bigger than this space. Oh, is it not true? Yeah. And she, her space is just here, going there. And she has this racket. There's W on it. What does the W mean? Wilson or something. William. Huh? William, yeah, so. And she's wearing a banner, and then she's wearing a short skirt, and then she has a Nike, whatever. That's all. Hook, whack, hook, whack. And after 1 hour, $500 million for doing what? Whack. I see the Lord using your gift to bless your life. I see your little gift. It may not be celebrated by anybody now. Stay with it. Train. And God. You know, when you win such tournament, normally they take them to the side. And then they ask you questions. And then when they took her to the side, and pressmen gathered, they said, how do you feel? He said, I feel great. How did you win this championship? Well, I train hard. I watch my diet. I work very hard, I push myself, and I study my opponent, and I just look through. She said the truth. She works hard. She pushes herself. She watch her dad. Work hard. Push yourself. The little gift you had, work hard. Push yourself. Break the barrier. Assert yourself. Don't go around begging people for money. Don't go about begging for help. Use your gifts. This week you are in Brother S house. There's nothing in the house. Yeah, you become a professional beggar. You have arms, you have legs, you are not disabled, you are nothing. You see, you don't have any disability at all. Your eyes, your nose, you breathe well, you eat well, you wee wee well. You poo-poo well. you sleep well, your arms, and still, you don't know what you're about in life. You don't have a gift. I don't know what I'm doing. And some people are so frustrated, they are contemplating suicide. How miserable can you be that you are standing, people without legs, people with one arm? There are people around the world who have disability, and they tell themselves disability is not inability. They have discovered some are stars, some are this, some are sport. There is a Paralympic Games going on at Rio de Janeiro 2016. These are disabled people winning gold medals, playing basket on a wheelchair, playing something. They are doing different kinds of sports. These are disabled people. You are an able person. You are complaining. It is a crime against God for making you able and you are poor. Are you there? What can you do? Can you trade? What can you do? Are you a painter? Are you a sculptor? What can you do? Do you have height? There was a guy in Japan, very tall. He was born very tall in Japan. And he used to be a laughing stock. Whenever we see children following him, people are taking his pictures. So the guy is extra tall. Going about, they mock at him, they laugh at him. Somebody saw him and said, look, I want to turn you into a star. Flew him from Japan and brought him to the U.S. and started training him how to play basketball. The guy doesn't jump. He plays the basketball. He'll be standing there. When they pass the ball to him, he doesn't jump. He stretches his hand and put the ball. The guy is a billionaire. So your height is a gift. There is a reason why God made you tall. Are you short? There's a reason why you are short. Money is in your size. Money is in your height. Do you know that Mr. Bean, when he started, he was a laughing stock of society? Mr. Bean, the way he walks. The guy is rich, richer than your whole family put together by being a comedian. So his comedy gift has made room for him. He is now a film star, Hollywood star. Anytime he appears, the guy, look, anytime we are bored in the house, say, bring Mr. Bean. Then they put Mr. Bean. We have all his movies. My children have all the movies of Mr. Bean. Mr. Bean, go here. Mr. Bean, he said, Mr. Bean Reborn. Hey, he was also like James Bond. He messed up big time. Praise the Lord. But Mr. Bean is rich, very blessed, lives in a big house. Just being a comedian. Are you a talk show host? Are you a whatever? What are you? By all means, when you go into yourself, you will know that God has given you a gift. And that gift is what will make room for you one day. Say, I hear you, Pastor. In the same book of Exodus chapter 14, the 14th chapter, Exodus 14, look at the verses that follow in verse 17. Exodus 14. Okay, let's look at verse, for time's sake, let's look at verse 15. And the Lord said to Moses, when he got to the Red Sea. And the Lord says to Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. But lift thou up thy rod, and stretch out thy hand over the sea and divide it, and the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. You see how the Lord, the way the Bible says, put, he said, but lift up thy rod, the one you have, and
and stretch out thy hand over the sea and do the division. Move, tell the people of Israel to move forward. Look, move forward with the gifts that you have, with the rod. Stretch forth thy rod, not the one we are bringing you from heaven, not the one that belongs to somebody else, but the one that belongs to you. He has used this rod, beloved, he has used this rod for so many years to tend the sheep, to tend the flock, to help. When you see the rod, the end of the rod is shaped in a certain way. And there's a reason why they do that, because when a sheep falls into a pit, they can use it, hook up the sheep that has fallen and pull it out. The rod had a certain curvature to help to pull out sheep and goats and things that fall into ditches and things. And that same rod has been with him for years. It is the same rod he used to enter Egypt. A rod didn't come from heaven. It is the gift you have, the one that belongs to you, the one you are familiar with. That is the one God is going to use to break through for you one day. Discover that gift. Don't go around becoming a professional beggar, asking people to help you. Hear that. Discover what you have. Step out. So when Moses stepped out in faith, he didn't step out in faith with the rod of somebody. He stepped out in faith with his own rod. So when he was crying out to God, the Lord said, why are you crying out to me? Use the rod you have and divide the sea yourself. Say amen. Ask somebody, where is your rod? Where have you left it? You've left your rod in your bedroom, roaming around offices and things, crying out to people, I don't have anything. I don't know why I'm here. I don't know why I was born. My mother and my father died. My mother and my father died. Whose mother and father hasn't died? My wife is here. She's lost the father and the mother. She has no mother. She has no father. She has no father. As a mother. One day she said, you are my father. You are my mother. I said, hey. So I'm the father. I'm the mother. I'm the husband. I'm the pastor. There are people walking around. There are people who were picked from the baller. Their mother gave birth to them and wrapped them and dumped them on refuse dump. Picked up by a stranger, raised in a home where they didn't go to proper primary school, whatever. An old lady just cared for a child that was found on the refuse dump. They are now managing directors of banks and companies. Don't tell me you don't have anything. Discover who you are. Are you a writer? Write. People have become blessed because of writing. Are you a newspaper columnist? Are you an editor? Larry King Live has resigned from interviewing, and the guy is richer than when he was a talk show person. His money is multiplying. Are you a boxer? Be careful, they will break your job and you can make somebody. I don't like boxing. I don't watch boxing. I don't like boxing at all. I don't like the way boxers train. They are training and punching a bag just to go and punch another human being. I don't like boxing. But if you're a gifted boxer, go to Bukom. Bukom Banku will train you. But beware of your jaw. You may come back with a locked jaw. How are you? Because they will shake your cadaver. Yeah. They are athletes. Usain Bolt. What's his name? Is that him? Usain Bolt, the Jamaican athlete. Yeah. He ran for how many seconds? 9.6 point something 0 seconds. The person who was second to him also had 9 point something. It was a fraction of a second. And the guy has become the fastest man in the world. The guy goes to discotheque and dance and shake the waist, because the guy is a billionaire. His legs, age has made room for him. Are you an athlete? Are you a footballer? Are you playing football among us?
Are you a footballer? Go and become rich and bring me some of the money. I wish I had 3 footballers in my church. I would have finished. They are tight alone. It's enough to wipe away all my sorrows. Footballers. £90,000 a week. £140,000 a week. When they take away all the taxes, they are left with about £70,000. £70,000. A tithe of it a week. I'll be smiling all the way to the bank. One day there was a certain footballer who wanted to marry a certain girl in this church. So they came and saw me. And I said, you want to marry my daughter? I said, yes, it's going to cost you. I told the guy, it's going to cost you. So, Reverend, I'm ready. I said, okay. I have to pay tight. Say amen. The guy left, was playing footballer. One day he came and said, Reverend, there's some money be somewhere. But this one is not for the church, it's for you. I said, really? I said, it's on the cross. When they collected the money, I was smiling all the way. A minute later, he called me, Reverend, I brought you some money, it's in a bank. I went to collect it. I said, eesh. After 3 months, the money didn't come again. I pray that there shall be footballers in this house. These guys, they don't go to school much. They don't speak good English. They play gutter to gutter, gutter to gutter, gutter to gutter. You see them play chess, gutter to gutter, gutter to gutter, gutter. They are falling down. They are hurting themselves. They are bruising themselves. They are putting iodine and everything. Now, they are in, some of them are in Brazil, in the UK, playing, and they are earning £90,000 a week by playing gutter to gutter, gutter to gutter. Your gift will make room for you. Raise your hand and say, my gift will make room for me. Discover that gift. Are you into real estate? Are you a planner, an organizer? Some of the profession that you feel God has blessed you with, they are not hailed, celebrated by society. So if you don't take care, you'll be intimidated and shy away from that work and think that it is not a proper work. People will laugh at me. Who told you that? Do it. What you feel God has called you to do, stay there. Are you an insurance broker? Stay there. Are you a teacher? There are teachers who are blessed. There are people who are into chess and canopies, and they are blessed. There are people at Chipotle Golf Course. There are some people, you see the Monday morning, 8 o'clock, you see them playing golf. Whack. Then they are partying. There are businesses they have set up, and their business is making money for them, and they are playing golf in the morning. So you will stand somewhere and say, hey, it's a kafua befie. But their gift has made room for them. Say, I hear you, Pastor. Say, I hear you, Pastor. You know, I was making an illustration in the first service about Fred's son. Fred, come here again. Fred has a son. The son is 12 years old. Yeah, give him a mic, please. This boy was born, and he wasn't born well. He came. Fred, stand here. Where's his mic? His son was born, and he had what we call what? Mention the name.
Cerebral palsy.
Cerebral. What is the? How does the cerebral palsy? How does the person become?
Basically, he has the brain that controls, the side of the brain that controls the movements.
The side of the brain that controls the movement.
For his condition, it's dead.
It's dead. There's a portion of his brain
yeah.
that is dead. That is what has caused his cerebral palsy.
Yes, because also he was born 25 weeks.
25 weeks. Normally we are supposed to be born
36, 37, 38,
but he was born 25 weeks, so he didn't come out well.
Well, that's
so. Which part of his body has his arm didn't come well?
His arm, he was born okay. I mean, everything was okay with him until he has been transferred from the hospital he was born into a major one because they couldn't have. And then, on the process in transferring him, a mistake was done with the arm.
the arm.
So he lost the arm as
he
well.
He lost the arm. So yes. He's born without, so no, he's lost the arm. So he only has one arm.
That's right, yeah.
And he has his brain, part of the brain, too. But what does this guy do?
Now, in his school, he's a motivational speaker.
He's the motivational speaker in his school.
Uh-huh. He got an award in the borough that we live, the area that we live. He got an award for motivating the people in the class. Now he's also into leadership training in the school.
The guy who is 12 is into leadership training. Yes. A cerebral palsy.
Yeah.
All right.
At least talking to his mates.
His
mates, because that's what the school has recognized. And he is the face of the school.
He's the face of the school.
That's right.
When I say you are the face of the school, what does that mean?
It means that the school doesn't do anything major in the borough without him. He's always involved.
The school doesn't do anything major without him.
No.
Because he's involved. He's like the face of the school. Everything revolves.
Everything is.
If you want to show an advert or something, it is his face.
Emmanuel is there.
He motivates them.
Wow. Yes, wow, yeah. Wow, wow. And then also, he's training himself to be a preacher.
He's training himself to be a preacher.
Yes. That's what, yeah.
Hallelujah. Are you clapping or you are just looking? Born 25 weeks. Cerebral palsy, immature, lost an arm, is a motivational speaker at the age 12. And he's 12 years old. How old are you? Who do you motivate? No, how this be shows? How old are you? This guy is not that they say, I've met this guy. And when you meet him, he will start preaching at once. He has scriptures flowing to his brains. Scripture, he's in a wheelchair. Does he walk?
No.
But the guy wants to be a preacher. He preaches, he listens to TD Jakes and everything. The guy's in a wheelchair. Don't tell me you were not given anything. God has given you something.
Sorry, Pastor. I spoke to him after the first service.
After the service, you spoke to him.
I spoke to him and I said, oh, Reverend Steve was preaching about you. And he said, what did he say? And I said, okay, we spoke so many things about you. And he said, did you tell him that I'm an usher in the church?
An usher in the church?
Yes, he's an usher in the church.
He's an usher in the church.
So
how does he usher people?
Well, he's in his chair and he distributes envelopes.
And
then he shakes hands as well.
He shakes hands as well with people.
Welcome you.
And welcome people into the church. Wow. You are an able person. You have arms and legs. You were born not 36 with 40 weeks. You were overdue. The time you were born, you had beard and claws. Overdue. When I met the guy and I listened to his language, the way he talks, the confidence of a 12-year-old in a wheelchair with cerebral palsy. I was blown away. Say amen. Which means, brother, you stand a better chance of making your life better than going to your mother's house and going to the kitchen. Mama, then at your age, you still go to your mother's house and go to the kitchen and go and eat a muase. My applications are obeying me. What are you talking about? Look into yourself. You have a gift. And motivate yourself. And encourage yourself. That you can also become a star. You can also become somebody. Say amen. Do you know that until Prophet Samuel met David, David was always at the backside of the desert wearing a shepherd dress with a shepherd bag and a sling. And he was always using the slingshot. You put a little stone and you slung it. And the purpose of the stone, Atuakwa, is to, when the sheep is running, and the sheep is straying away from the flock, then David, afar off, instead of running to chase the lamb, will just pick a small stone, put it in a sling, and then he will slang it. And the stone will fall right in front of the sheep, and the sheep will know that he's been asked to come back to the floor. Then he will turn around and join his friend. He doesn't chase. So he looks around, he sees one of the sheep going, he pick a stone, whack, and you see the stone flying. It will not hit. It will land in front of the sheep, and the sheep will return. Now, that skill was developed after many years of being at the backside of the desert. He made mistakes. Sometimes his stone went too far, too short. Sometimes it hit the sheep, whatever. But through the training and all the ups and downs, he developed the skill. So by the time he was anointed and he came into the battlefield and he saw Goliath roaring and challenging the whole of Israel, suddenly he thought about his slingshot. And he said, well, I'm prepared to take care of Goliath. They rehearsed the matter to Saul. Saul brought him and said, well, I hear you want to take care of Goliath. He said, yes, I'm ready. And he said, prepare him for battle. They put on an armor, his shield, his sword, his everything, his boot. The guy took a step, took another one. He said, no, that's not what I use. I know my weapon. I know what I'm comfortable with. I know my comfort zone. I know what God has given to me. They took it off. Some might have asked him, so what are you going to use for the battle? He goes out and picks 5 small stones. He said, are you going to use these stones? He said, yeah, I'm used to it. I'm used to these stones. He said, wow, how do you fight Goliath with these stones? He said, okay, I'm comfortable with it. They told Goliath that someone was coming. He said, yeah, this place is boring. I need action. Then suddenly, David appears. He said, is that all that Israel can bring? Is that all that Israel has? And David took a look at the guy and looked at his forehead. He's used to slanging that shot many, many times. He has done it many times. He knows exactly the where the stone must land. So as soon as he saw him, he said to him, look, you come to me with sword and spear, but I'm coming to you in the name of the Lord of hosts. Today the Lord will deliver you into my hands and I'll cut off your head. You just watch it. He picked 5 small stones, put the 4 in his, and then put the one there, and then started whacking it, whack, 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 all over the place and sizing himself up. And then Goliath now prepares himself for battle, removes his sword, prepares his shield, and looks at David. David doesn't move at all. He's used to it. Whack, 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 whack. If you meet David, if you meet Goliath, ask him, the speed, the velocity, the accuracy with which the stone hit his forehead, he couldn't imagine it. The Bible said, and the stone sank into his forehead. It means that it was calculated. It went with speed, backed by the Spirit of God. Your work will be backed by the Spirit of God. It will not miss its target. It will not meet its, it will be driven by the Spirit, because your gift, the anointing of God will come upon that gift, and it will catapult you to a height unimaginable. Are you there? What can you do? Are you a painter? Paint to the best of your ability. When you want to marry, and the lady asks you, what work do you do? Don't hesitate. I'm a painter. I paint people's houses. I'm a professional painter. Do you have a house for me to paint for you? I know how to make paint. Don't say, well, actually, I was supposed to be a doctor, but a few devilish things came my way. So I decided that this thing, I would just be hanging around trying to paint a few places, but the actual, you see, calling was for me to not become a medical doctor. But I said, now this didn't work. Nonsense, my brother, nonsense. Are you telling me that painters are not also rich? I have a painter who paints my house. When he gives you the estimate, you need bank loan to pay him. Be happy with your paint work. Paint with profession. Paint very well. Wear your helmet. Wear your glove. Select coral. Mix with sickens. Develop new colors. Be skillful in it. And you end up painting the president's house. They will fly you from Ghana to go and paint international buildings. You will have paint. Be happy with it.
That is what you came into the world with. Don't look down upon your gift and think that somebody's gift, a doctor, a lawyer, is proper than a painter. Who told you that? A doctor's work is a doctor's work. A lawyer is also, you are also a painter. You are also a carpenter. You are also a hairdresser. You are also a beautician. You find yourself making up at Hollywood. That is where you are ending. Where after making up, you have $60,000 wired into your account. So don't look down upon what your God has given you and start looking at accountants, lawyers, diplomats. So these are the good ones. Say amen. You're also a beautician. You're also a professional painter. You paint buildings. Very soon, you can number the building contracts you have. Say amen. I have a certain carpenter guy who comes to work in my house. Anytime he works, there are always flaws in his work. Anytime he does his work, we have to redo it again. Somebody else introduced another guy to me. Then the guy came and said, "Oh, Reverend, this door was not fixed well." Then he told me what was wrong with the door. This one was not there. I said, "Okay, do it the proper." The guy did the work. When he finished, added more money to his money. So straight, so correct. I said, "From now onward, you work for me." The guy said, "Well, we'll try. No, you're not doing. The guy has a lineup of jobs. Just his carpentry work, woodwork, fixing doors, making sure the doors are straight. Skillfully learn your job very well with passion. Skillfully learn your job very well. Be passionate about it. Make sure your tiling, your POP work is well done. When there's something wrong with it, remove it and do it again. Lose to gain. And very soon, you can't handle your contracts. Young men are walking around. Uncle, can you find some 20 CDs for me so that I will know? Uncle, can you find, whenever I close from church, you see people walking around. Uncle, what have you been given? A professional begging ministry? Say amen. That single stone that left the slingshot of David into the forehead of Goliath was the beginning of David's fame. But he was at the backside of the desert many times using the sling. Made many mistakes. But by the time he met Goliath, he was skillful. By the time you come out of your backside of the desert, you'll be skillful. Are you listening to me? Yeah. By the time you come out, you'll be something else. Because God knows you, knows your temperament, and decided to give you this particular gift. Celebrate it. Celebrate your gift. Say amen. And sometimes it takes a long time to discover what you are, because all this year you'll be roaming around trying to be like somebody. But at a point, you will see that this is who you are. Say amen. I'm not a footballer. I'm not a basketballer. I'm a preacher. I preach. And I love preaching. And I preach almost every day. Say amen. We traveled to Asaba in Delta State. I think on Wednesday or so. Kafu, is it Wednesday? We got there on Thursday. Yeah, we got there Thursday. And then we preach when? Friday. No, Thursday. Thursday evening, they went and put that in some weird time. They gave us time to preach. And I mounted the pulpit, took my scriptures. There were so many people there. When I entered the auditorium, Kafu, did anybody know me in the auditorium? Nobody even knew. I just walked into the auditorium. They said, I sit there. The only person who knew who I was the host, the guy who invited us. The rest of the pastors, the bishops were all seated there. People have spoken since morning. So I think I was the last person to speak. Yeah, last to speak. It's like, what is this guy coming to say? So I put my Bible down, open my scriptures. I sing one song. Maybe sang one song and open my text and fired. Wow. The anointing from heaven came upon my tabernacle.
took the microphone, the whole place erupted. Kafu is my witness. The whole place was shaking. When I finished, the bishops were standing. They were asking the guy, who is this guy? Where did he come from? Fired the place. When I finished, I gave the microphone and I went to my hotel. Calls started coming to my hotel. And I was scheduled to speak in the following day in the morning. On my way to speak, they said we should go back to the hotel because the time I'm come to speak is only 1 hour. They want me to take a longer time. Then I went back to the hotel. They picked me at 2 o'clock. I went back, took the scriptures, opened the scriptures, fired again. Hey, fired. When I was firing, nobody was sitting down. People were standing. Fired and everything. And then I was told that my plane that I was going to leave, because I have to come here on Saturday for the women and then Sunday preaching. And the plane was on the tarmac at Asaba Airport. This was in the middle of my sermon. So I just put my microphone down and started storming out. I was mobbed by the people. People were pulling my jacket, pulling my shirt, laying their hands on my head and putting it upon their head. I received that grace. I was mobbed. Protocol have to come, shove people away, and they shoved me into a vehicle and whisked me away from the place. A gift, just a gift. The gift of preaching. Say amen. Gift of, we were about 9 or so speakers. When I finished my session, the guy called me when I arrived. The following day was Saturday. He said, Reverend, tapes were sitting. When your tapes are produced, the tapes got finished. They'll produce another one. All got finished. All your friends, the other tapes, I don't know about, they are not my friends. I just came to do God's will. He said, your tapes are sold out. The people want you back next year. The people, everybody is asking of you. People are Googling you and going on the website to check you out. I was new in Delta State. I've never been there before. But the gift that I have been here preaching every day, every time, preaching here now, carried me to a place I have never been. And the gift made room for me. I see your gift making room for you in a nation, in a place where you have never been. By your discipline, your proficiency, you make mistakes at home, you correct them, and your astute nature will carry you to a place. And brother, it will be a major breakthrough for you. And you know how I got to Asaba. It's very funny. A certain woman, a Nigerian woman, came to my house in my absence and said that she heard my tape on the net and told the husband that we have to bring this man to Ibadan. So they came to my house. When they came to me, I have traveled, gone somewhere. And then later they gave me the invitation. I traveled with Kafui to Ibadan. It was a pastor's conference, thousands of pastors. And I preached. When I finished preaching there, it was, what was the word? Chaos. When I finished preaching at Ibadan, chaos. The place, this was, I want you at Delta State. I want you at Enugu State. I said, hey, I'm not going anywhere. Because those times, those were the height of the Boko Haram. I said, hey, I have wife and children, I have members. I don't want to go to all those areas. When I got there, when I finished preaching, I speak, and I finished preaching, the whole place. You see, I am here. People are used to my preaching. People are familiar with my preaching. But I'm here. I make mistakes in my preaching. I correct it. I change it. Now, when I am there on the international front, and the oil, falls on your tabernacle. I see, I can't handle my Nigerian appointment. There are too many, and I'm scared of, excuse the Nigerians, I'm scared of. Nigerians, I love you. Nigerians, I love you very much. But I fear that place. Whilst we were in a Swiss hotel in Lagos, I heard, boom! It was a shot. I said, yes. God. Katabaya kasakaya. You don't laugh. Oh. Oh, just one shot. Because I know that some of these Boko Haram, they can invade hotels and say, okay, if you don't know how to recite the Quran, if you can recite the Quran, stand here. If you can recite the Quran, stand here. I say, yes. I don't know any verse in the Quran. I went out, I looked, I called the front desk. That what did I hear? Is there a gunshot? I said, Reverend, is there Reverend? There's nothing to worry about. Everything is okay. I said, thank God. I said, is there security in this hotel? He said, there's security. And I didn't sleep again. In tongues, katabayara, batakata, I paid the blood. When we landed in Asaba, and we, Kafui, when we landed and we're going back to the hotel, what was happening? It was raining. I went with all my clothes wet to the washroom, changed it and everything. And then it was raining and everything. I went, as it was raining, they were checking us in. They said we should go and board the plane. Hey, go and board the plane while it was raining. We boarded the plane. The plane went up in the air. Kafu, how was the plane? The plane was dancing like this. I say, yeah, Nigerians. Bad weather. All the bad weather incidents that brought planes down all came into my head. I say, I remove it from my spirit. I shall not die by plane accident. I have a church. I have a wife and children. Meanwhile, the plane was like this. You'll be laughing. You don't know what it is. The plane was like this. It was a small plane. Small plane. The plane was like this. When the plane was about to land, the plane was like this. They put the plane down. When they put the plane, I said, Lord, I thank you. I'm on the ground. I thank you. So when I came home and the guy said, Reverend, we have called Kafui. We have booked you for next year. I said, hold on. Take it easy. People are begging for preaching appointment. Preaching appointment are chasing me and I'm turning them away. Why? Because of the gift. That is what God has given to me. That is what I work with. That is what has sent me to nations. So your gift will carry you before kings, before presidents, before people. So develop the gift, celebrate the gift, work on the gift, and the gift will carry you to your prophetic destiny. God bless you and I love you all. Shall we rise? You're all I want. You're all I need. You're all I want. Oh, honey.
your hands, all ye people. I'm going to read two scriptures for you. The first scripture is Proverbs 17:8. We are going to pray with it. Proverbs 17:8, it says, Proverbs 17, a gift is as a precious stone in the eyes of him that have it. A gift is as a precious stone in the eyes of him that had it. Whithersoever it turneth, it prospereth. If you turn the gift, if you work at it, if you train in it, it will prosper you. I see you praying and turning your gift for prosperity. Say, dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
I see my gift.
I see my gift.
It's a precious stone.
It's a precious stone.
In my eyes.
In my eyes.
As I pray, Lord.
As I pray, Lord.
Help me.
Help me.
To turn it around.
To turn it around.
For it can prosper.
For it can prosper.
Shall we pray?
In the name of Jesus. Father, we pray. Every gift in any ability, any talent, any grace that you have graced us with. Father, in the name of Jesus, for our prayer, as we pray, oh God, let your blessing come upon it. Let it be turned around for our prosperity. Let it be turned around. Let it work in the name of Jesus. Let it become sharper in the name of Jesus. Let it become stronger in the name of Jesus. Let it become active in the name of Jesus. Let it work and work in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the Father, he shall bring us the blessings, the able God, the enlargement, the increase, the advancement that we need. He shall bring us the joy that we desire. Let every gift that we are wired with, any gift, any talent, any ability, in the name of Jesus, within us, hey, calabros in the caleria, any power,
Jesus,
that is lying in us, cause it to be active, in Jesus' name.
The second scripture is Proverbs 18:16. Proverbs 18:16. A man's gift maketh room for him.
Amen.
And bringeth him before great men.
Amen.
We are going to pray that the small gift that God has given to you.
Jesus.
Are you a sports person?
Jesus.
Are you a tailor?
Jesus.
Are you a seamstress?
Jesus.
Are you a talk show host?
Jesus.
Are you an investment banker?
Jesus.
Are you an insurance broker?
Jesus.
What are you?
Jesus.
May that gift make room for you.
Amen.
And bring you before great men. Say, dear Lord.
Dear Lord Jesus.
This afternoon, the gift
you have given me,
may it make room
for me,
and bring me
before great men.
As I pray,
clapping my hands,
I release
that greatness.
Shall we pray
in the name of Jesus, Father? Let the gift of God given unto me. Let a gift of God that was that in my life make room for me. May it bring me before great men. May it bring me before kings. May it bring me, oh God, into where, oh God, you have ordained for my life. Let your power bring excellence upon my gift. Let the workings of your anointing mixed up, oh God, with my gift and talents and ability. Father, in the name of Jesus, bring me honor. Bring me honor. Bring me honor. Bring me lifting. Let your spirit, your anointing and power mixed, oh God, with the gift, with the ability, with the book, the talent, in the name of Jesus, be sharper in
Jesus.
The name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
There is a very important prayer I want you to pray.
Yes, Lord.
Samuel said, from my childhood,
Jesus,
I have walked with you,
Jesus,
and I have served God before you,
Jesus.
Now I am gray-headed.
Jesus.
Testify against me,
Jesus.
Whose ox have I taken,
Jesus?
Whom have I defrauded,
Jesus?
It means that someone walk with integrity.
Yes.
Someone walk with honesty.
Yes.
And upright. May the Lord make you an honest person.
Jesus name.
That spirit of honesty, integrity will carry you to places beyond your
Jesus name.
Joseph had a dream. His gift was dreams and visions and dreams and visions. And the dreams were dreaming in his father's house. He took it to Potiphar's house, took it to the prison house. And from the prison, the same dream, the same interpretation of dream, took him to his palace. Wherever your gift is, I see your gift meandering its way from obscurity into the lamplight. From obscurity, from nothing into something.
Amen.
May that thing you have started, small on your veranda, on your porch, may it grow to become thing. Say, I hear you.
I hear you.
Say, Father.
Father.
My gift.
My gift.
My calling.
My calling.
My rod.
My rod.
May be small.
May be small.
But before your eyes.
Before your eyes.
It shall be greatly increased.
Shall,
we pray?
In the name of Jesus. Let it be, O God. No matter how small it may be. No matter how I start, O God. Let your grace bring increase. Let your power bring enlargement. Let your grace cause this, O God, to blossom and might be a small seed. My Father, you're watering. Father, you're nurturing. Father, your blessings will make it greater. Will make it bigger. Will make it, O God, be a blessing. In the name of Jesus. Lebra sakaturia delelala. Ripokoria talabara. Lebras korelebria sanda katuria. Rekele babara sandiria. Rekele brasakaya perea. Let grace abound. Let grace abound. Let grace abound. Concerning our calling. Concerning our role. Concerning our giftings. Concerning our abilities. Concerning, O God, that which you have called us into. Let grace abound. That it shall prosper. Let grace abound. That it shall grow. Let grace abound. That it shall increase. Let grace abound. In the name of Jesus. Lebrosa baraba sindicaleria. Lepacaturia delebarosa. Ricalaba zikeleba. Labrandosi balosa. Jesus' name.
I want us to do something we did in the first service. I want to sow a seed into your gift.
Jesus.
Sow a seed into your gift.
Jesus.
Say amen. Take a seed. Take 100 cedis. Take 50. Take something. 200 cedis. Take $1,000. Write a check and say, Father, I am sowing this seed into my gift, which may be small, but with this seed, I see my gift increasing,
Jesus.
Multiplying. Come to the altar.
Jesus.
If you can't come, there'll be baskets on the second
level.
Say, Father.
Father.
As I come to the altar.
As I come to the
as
altar.
As I bring my seed.
As I bring my seed.
To sow into my gift.
To sow into my gift.
I see a multiplication.
I see a multiplication.
I see a breakthrough.
I see a breakthrough.
Shall we pray right now?
In the name of Jesus. Father, by our seed, O Lord, we connect to the anointing and grace. We connect to your power, Father, to affect our grace, our giftings, our ability, our talent, our calling, our rod. Father, for a multiplication, for a breakthrough, for an increase, for an advancement, let it be, O God, that it shall grow by your power. Lebaro zikere rara sanilalola. Libres kiri bris caloria delelela. By this seed, O God, we connect to the source that never ends, to the source that there is never shortage, the source of God's strength, the source of God's power, God's blessing, God's grace, God's strength, God's wisdom, God's understanding. In the name of Jesus, that the power of God will come upon our works. The power of God will come upon our the works of our hands. The power of God will come upon our hopes, our businesses, our calling. In the name of Jesus, let the power of God take over. In the name of Jesus, we connect with the grace of God. We connect with the anointing of God. We connect with the power of God. In the name of Jesus, by our seed, let grace abound. By our seed, let anointing come upon us. By our seed, let supernatural strength, supernatural insight, our wisdom of God, the power of God to get wealth,
come upon us in the name of Jesus. Supernatural ideas, supernatural power, let it come, let it consume us, let it help us in the name of Jesus. Labra sikere barasa deleala, rikere babarosa deleala, rekere barasa da kaderia, rekalabosa kaya derea, rekele babarasa derea, rakaya katuria derea, rekele babarasa derea, rekalabarosa, rekalabasa de kalea. Jesus' name.
What people say, bigger than what people say, be bigger than what people say,
bigger than what people say. Jehovah, you are big,
you are stronger,
you are stronger, bigger than what.
Stronger.
You are stronger,
oh, oh.
Bigger than what people say.
Oh, what
bigger, bigger than what people say.
You are
bigger, bigger than what people say.
You are
bigger, bigger than what people say.
Hey,
bigger than what people say.
Jehovah,
you are bigger,
you are strong,
you are stronger,
bigger than what
people say.
Jehovah,
you are bigger, you are stronger, bigger than what people say,
bigger than what people call you.
Than what people say.
Hey! You are bigger than what people can imagine.
Bigger than what people say.
Jehovah,
you are bigger.
Yes, you are.
You are stronger.
Bigger than
what people say.
Everybody say you are.
You are bigger.
Coming big.
Yeah.
I see you breaking forth. I see you taking on international dimensions.
Jesus' name.
I see your gift taking you to unimaginable places.
Jesus' name.
I see that your beginning may be small.
Jesus.
But your latter end,
Jesus,
shall be greatly increased.
Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Give the Lord a mighty shout.
Amen.
Amen. Well, we are closing now. If you forgot your tithe, or maybe you are in the choir, you didn't come for it, this is a sign. You can still come and leave your seed at the altar. If you didn't come for it, you can come and leave your seed at the altar. If you forgot your tithe, people forget their tithes and all, they give it to someone. Don't give your tithe to nobody. Bring it to the altar. We are closing. Say amen. Hallelujah. Don't forget that School of Evangelism is still being registered. So make sure you join the School of Evangelism. Write your name at the tent where the Christ Aurora World Dex is. Just Worship Season 7 is on the way. And October 7th is going to be a Friday. It's going to be from 6 p.m. till 10 p.m. It's just about worship Jesus. It's going to be awesome. Say amen. Pastors, wives, and lady pastors, you meet on Thursdays from 7:30 to 8:30. And charisma ladies, you meet from 6 p.m. to 7:30. Take note. All intercessors, we have a special topic we want to pray about. So Tuesday, I want to see all of you. Prophetic encounter on on the 9th, on the from Thursday 9 a.m. Say amen. Men. Well, the charisma lady is over. Men, we are taking our center stage, taking our place, and we'll make the women very happy. We have allowed them to go forward. They had a very big service this morning, very huge service this morning. It was awesome. It's our turn now. Next week, we are coming out with all our dates, with our team and our speakers, and all men, without exception, must participate in this up-and-coming men's convention. Say amen. Well, bless God for today. It's been a happy day, and I know that God is going to bless you. Well, you want to give your life to Jesus Christ? This morning, I made a beautiful altar call, and people came forward. It's your turn to give your life to Jesus. It's your turn to be born again. It's your turn to be a member of this family. If you are here, you want to give your life to Jesus. By the count of three, show me your hand. You may be the only person here, and I'll pray for you. 1, 2, and 3, show me your hand. I'll pray for you. Anybody here, you want to give your life to Jesus? You want to dedicate your life to the Lord? You want to be born again? Show me your hand. I want to pray for you right now. If there is anybody around, wave your hand. If there's anybody, is there anybody? Is there anybody? Okay, come forward here. Come forward here. Come forward here. Give him a hand as he comes. I love you guys. Wow. Lady, give your life to Jesus. Be born again. God is going to use you greatly. You look like a rich man. You become very rich one day. Wow. You look like Oprah Winfrey's daughter. May you have Oprah Winfrey's kind of money one day. Wow. Let's pray together with them as they give their life to Jesus. Let's say, dear Lord Jesus, this afternoon, we surrender all to you. Jesus, receive me and write my name in heaven. From today, I am born again. My sins are washed by the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross to celebrate my resurrection. Father, thank you that on that day, I shall see your face. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow. Don't go. This gentleman wants to talk to you for a few minutes. Do you have your bag there? You have your bag or something? All right. Pick your bag quickly. Do you have a Bible or something? You're okay. Good. I like your jacket. You're a nice guy. All right. So let's give it up for them as they go, as he talks with them. All right. Somebody cannot find her car keys. I think she lost her car keys. If you have found any car keys anywhere, please bring it forward. And then we will announce it to the person. Let's rise and close the service. Somebody cannot find her car keys. If you have those car keys, please bring it forward. Shall we close? Hey, I see one of my deacons in the house. Hey, let's give it up for our deacon. All the way from, where are you coming from? Abidjan or what? Where? Kenya. Wow, Kenya. We celebrate you. I forgot his name again. I cannot forget that name. Deacon Akolo. You are still the same. You haven't grown tall. You haven't grown short. You haven't grown further. The same. Bless God. One of our strong church members. Amen. Give it up for Deacon Akolo and his spiritual wife for coming. They've been away for so many years. Their children have grown. We love you. Amen. Wow. Our bank lady, thank you also for coming from holidays, short break. Grace of Grace Hall. Amen. Buy the tapes and the CDs. Next week, I will conclude my series on stepping out, and then you can have the whole set. You can go on a net podcast and listen to the ones you have missed. In Jesus' name. From the tree on to victory is Ivorian contingent. Their first lady left this morning, but they left a few of them. There are about five of them. Raise your hands. Five of them from Ivory Coast. Vash Dene Ministries. I preach in their church every time. Come. Here, come here. Let people see you. Vash Dene. Wow. They came. There were about five that came all the way from Abidjan. They go to a church that are preaching. It's a very big church. And they are here today. Say a few words before we close, yeah? Say a few. Who speak? You? All right. wanted to say some French, but the friend didn't come. Turn around, turn around, turn around.
Praise the Lord. We were so blessed to be able to come here for the conference. Mama Jane, you don't know how blessed we all were by this conference. This was personally my first time in Ghana. So thanks to you, I've been able to come. I've always wanted to come, and the Lord has made a way through you. All the speakers were fantastic. And Daddy's intervention yesterday just blew us away, like you say it so well. So thank you very much. From Abidjan, we send you greetings. And we'll take all that blessing and try and share it with everybody there. Thank you very much.
Merci, merci, merci. How do you say safe journey when you go back? How do you say safe journey? Oh, bon voyage. Bongo to, bongo to, bon voyage, bon, 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 bon. Tout le monde, bon voyage. Écoutez, écoutez bien. The Lord bless and keep you. May his face shine upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and prosper your way and make you great and make you a phenomenon and make you a star in Jesus' name. Greet 10 people and tell them the Lord is going to make you a star. God bless you. See you next week.